Yo guys, Jonathan here, and over the weekend while I was busy talking about desks, you may have seen LG drop their brand new G6. Fortunately, I was able to get my hands on it, check it out, see what the hype is about, and these are my thoughts 48 hours later. Now for starters with the G6, LG has thankfully ditched the modular design of its predecessor, the G5, and instead gone with a safer all glass, all metal body that is super pretty, and while it may not be groundbreaking, I really like it. The one thing you do lose with the lack of modularity though is the removable battery. For me, that's never been a huge issue with the abundance of battery banks and fast charging. For some people, that may be a deal breaker, but honestly, I think it is a small price to pay in turn for what yields to be a much better overall phone. Now, as far as the battery goes, internally, this is packing 3300 milliamps, which isn't bad, but it's also not great. I kind of wish LG would have pushed this a little further, maybe somewhere north of 4000, but overall, you should still get some really solid battery life with the G6, and more importantly, like The Rock says,
finally,
wireless charging is here. Now, wireless charging isn't game-changing or revolutionary, and yes, we've seen it on a ton of other phones before, but it's 2017, which means it's about time every phone includes wireless charging. I'm looking at you, Apple, so thumbs up to LG on this one. So while the removable battery may be gone, the one thing power users can still rejoice and hold on to dearly is expandable storage via microSD. You're probably gonna hear some fancy tech talks run around like expandable up to 2 terabytes of storage. Roping people back to reality for a second, the biggest current microSD card available is 1/8 that capacity, and even that is around $200. So you can imagine, even if a 2 terabyte microSD card does come out, you're gonna have to sell some blue sky to afford it. Beyond that, the LG G6 features the USB-C port, which is a thumbs up because everything should be USB-C. We also still see the classic LG power button and fingerprint reader on the back, which is a little weird if you've never used it, but once you spend some time with it, it feels really natural. Now, beyond the design changes, I think maybe what stood out most to me with the G6 has gotta be the display, because it's really different than anything you're normally used to seeing. This has a 5.7-inch IPS LCD display with a resolution of 2880 by 1440. And if you're thinking to yourself, that math sounds a little off, you sir are correct. And that's because this isn't your traditional 16:9 aspect ratio, it's actually 18:9. So what this means is gonna be a little longer when you're holding it upright and a little wider when you're holding it landscape. It is gonna be a little bit weird when you're watching movies and videos that aren't 18:9, and honestly, that is the majority of them out there. But if you can get past the black bars on the side, which really aren't that big of a deal, it's actually kinda cool what you can do with the extra space. For starters, multitasking works really, really well because essentially you're getting two perfect squares, one on the top, one on the bottom, which results in more room for activities. Actually, what I found really useful though is once you're in the camera app with that extra space up top, you can actually see all your recent photos that you've taken. And again, much like a lot of things you'll start to notice with the G6, it's not game changing or revolutionary, but it's actually really useful. On top of that, one of the coolest things with the G6 is the fact that you're getting more screen real estate in a smaller overall package. So for example, here is the iPhone 7 Plus. This is a 5.5-inch phone, and side by side next to the G6, you can see that is physically smaller, but has more screen real estate. So that right there honestly is kind of a big deal. I've always thought the iPhone 7 Plus was kind of bulky and too big for one-handed use, so the fact that you could fit a bigger screen in a smaller package that feels better in your hand is kind of a win. Beyond that, the bezels, or rather lack thereof on the G6, are a beautiful, beautiful thing. The curved elements are a super nice touch, and you kind of just want to stare at it and appreciate the display. So day two is when I got to spend some time with the camera, or cameras I should say, on the G6. I gotta admit though, every time I stare at this thing, I cannot unsee the monkey tablet stand. Regardless though, with this guy, you're getting twin 13 megapixel shooters, the first of which being your standard portrait lens, and the second being an ultra wide get everything in the shot lens. What I particularly like about this on the G6 is the fact that you don't lose any quality jumping back and forth from lenses. Here are a couple pictures, the first of which being the standard lens. I'm gonna then hop over to the ultra wide lens, and you can see for it being really gloomy, overcast, and nasty outside nearing sunset, both of these do a fantastic job, and you don't really notice any quality difference at all. Overall, for the past couple years, I've really liked what LG's done in terms of smartphone cameras, and with the G6, it is no different here. I definitely do wanna still put it through its paces a little more, but overall, so far, I am super impressed with the camera. Now, another bright note with the G6 is the fact that it is now water resistant. Just doing some basic things like tossing it in water, taking some video, everything worked perfectly. And while those tests weren't crazy by any means, I do have some plans for some more extreme water tests featuring the G6. And if that's something you want to see, make sure you guys drop a like down below. Now, this is a pre-production model, so I'm not gonna dive too deep into the software or the OS. You do get Android 7.1 Nougat, which is definitely a plus. But in terms of really diving deep in there with the software, I'm definitely gonna wait until I get my hands on the final retail model. I will say, I definitely don't mind LG's skin. It's pretty light and for the most part stays out of your way. And there are some things that I actually kind of enjoyed, like when you swipe across the screen, the text kind of bounces with you, which is strangely satisfying. But overall, gone is the bastard child G5. Here is the G6. And I think it's safe to say LG is back in the smartphone game. Aside from that, thank you guys very much for watching. If you haven't yet, definitely feel free to subscribe. You're probably not going to want to miss that water test. And if you're thinking to yourself, what is that beautiful setup? You can check out that video here. This is Jonathan, and I will catch you guys later. So day two is when I got... Oh, come on, man. My mouth is frozen shut. Like Elsa.